Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Pokémon Crystal Wedlocke. In the last episode, we beat Faulkner, and so now we're gonna go to the Sprout Tower. And honestly, we're probably gonna completely sweep through the whole place. They're at level 3. The first few trainers are at level 3. Then they get to level 7, eventually, at the top. And then they are at- then the final person's at level 10. So... it doesn't help that I was slightly over-leveled for Faulkner. By slightly over-leveled, I mean literally slightly. Just we won one level. And I'm gonna skip the trainers if I can, because they're level 3. We don't need to fight them at this point. I apologize for over-leveling before Faulkner, but I didn't try to, as you can see. I just did, yeah. Well, you stand guard and do things, and you guard a place, but you don't know why you're guarding it. You just guard it because. So as it's being the Bellsprout Tower, they're all gonna have Bellsprouts. Yeah, they all have Bellsprouts, except the last couple trainers randomly have a Hoothoot. So, Lapis is just gonna confuse everything. I guess I haven't used Lapis since it evolved, so that's why, Confusion is not up top yet. That looks a good order. Confusion, be up top. Alright. So, yeah. Not really sure just what to say right now. Earlier today, as of the day I recording this, I'm wondering if this series should be, a daily series, like the Sun Nuzlocke was. Or was that too many videos, and that it was hard for people to keep up with it? I asked a question like that on my Twitter as of the day this would be recorded. So, probably a decision will have been made by the time you're watching this, but I guess if you have an opinion, let me know. If you think this series should be daily, like the Sun Nuzlocke was, or if you'd prefer to go back to the way I used to do things, which was 3 times a week, usually Monday, Wednesday, Friday. But back then when I did that, I also usually uploaded on Blue Gator Gaming, my other channel. It's for non-Pokemon stuff, but I don't really feel like going back to that anytime soon. And if I did, I don't know, I probably wouldn't continue the playthrough I'm doing right now on it, which was Minish Cap. I'm gonna finish it someday. Promise you, I'll finish it someday. I just don't have an interest to finish it right now. I feel like I'd start yet another series on that channel and then come back to Minish Cap later. But, I don't know. Very few people are actually interested in that channel in the first place, which is why I haven't honestly gone back to it in a while. So yeah, for those that don't know, I have a second channel, but it's not active right now because it's not many people want to watch it, according to, you know, it not having very many views. So that's why I was focusing on this channel, and I made sure to post Sun daily, but I hadn't posted any after that was over. Well, nothing, there's nothing for a while, and so I'm wondering, well, when I jump into this series, should I just do it daily, or... 3 times a week. The reason it was easy to do the Sun Nuzlocke daily is because I had every single episode recorded before I even uploaded a single one. Because that's how it was. It was blind. That was the purpose of it. But with this series, I don't really need to record the whole thing before I upload anything. And seeing as the Johto games are really freaking long, because there's 2 whole regions to go through, I don't think I'll be able to do that. So if I did do daily, there's a very, very high chance there would be a point where, like, well, crap, I'm out of episodes. You're gonna have to guys wait a few days for me to start the daily things again. So, but if that's not possible, then, I don't know. I could just go back to the three videos a week. That I could probably do, no questions asked, but no promises, I guess. So yeah, if you have an opinion, feel free to let me know. About that, not any opinion ever. Well, I guess if any opinion on anything at all. Yeah, sure, why not? Why the heck not? What's the worst that'll happen? Alright, we're just fighting these guys with Bellsprouts. I'm sure you guys can tell, like, that what's going on without me having to explain it. And I know I'm not super effective anymore with Amethyst, but we're at level 10. So, we're probably gonna get hit a couple times, but we'll be fine. And Amethyst is paired with Lapis, so... They're together, so I can easily switch and be perfectly fine. And that was it. That's all he had. Good job. My training is incomplete. Correct. You were at level, what, 6? Yeah, you've got 94 levels to go before your training is complete. Yeah. Alright, Sage Neil. Wonder if he likes kneeling. Wonder if he has brothers, sit, stand, and lean. I'm sorry, wow. I'm really struggling for jokes. Or have I always been like this? I don't honestly know. Let me know. Is my head that is bright? No, you know. No, you're not that bright. And, I don't need to fight that guy over there. What was that? What did he do? You are indeed skilled as a trainer. As promised, here is your HM. But let me say this. You should not treat your Pokemon- You should treat your Pokemon better. The way you battle is far too harsh. Pokemon are not tools of war. Humph! He claims to be the elder, but he's weak! Because old and weak are totally opposites. It stands to reason. I'd never lose to fools who battle up being nice. Ugh, I only care about strong Pokemon that can win. I really couldn't care less about weak Pokemon. Why well, ran his escape rope? Dude, it's like, it takes like less than a minute to get out. You wasted an escape rope. Good job. I found an escape rope here. Okay, I'm not gonna use that. I'm not gonna be a noob like Lyron and, you know. Also, for the record. Oh crap, I found a Pokemon. Oh, by the way, you can only, the only Pokemon I could possibly catch here is Ghastly, because the only things you can find here are Rattata and Ghastly. And look, I already have a Rattata, so. But the problem is Ghastly's only found at night. And I have a very strong feeling I'm never actually gonna record at night, just based on how I've been recording lately. So, I may have to catch it off screen. So just for you guys, this thing's swiggling in the center here. When I was little, I swore this was a Game Boy. See, look at it. See, it's just a Game Boy. The top screen and the bottom is, you know, just doesn't have buttons. I swore this was just a random Game Boy sitting there. I honestly did not know it was supposed to be a pillar until someone told me, and I'm like, nah, it looks nothing like a pillar. And then I still did not think it looks like a pillar until Heart Gold Soul Silver came out, and I saw, oh, the dark part is it, like, vanishing into the ceiling. And, yeah, I don't know how else you'd make a pillar sprite in these old games, but wow, it so still does not look like a pillar to me. I could kinda see it, but it's a real stretch. It's a real stretch. Okay, so what does this dude have? Actually, I already know what he has. He has a Bellsprout, and Hoothoot. I believe they're all level 10, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, never mind. No, the Bellsprout's level 7, the Hoothoot's at level 10. That's right. Because. That other trainer I just avoided, he also has a Bellsprout and a Hoot, and I believe they're both 7. So, like I said, they start at 3, then they randomly jump to 6 and 7, then 10. So. And yay, level for Amethyst! Woohoo! Alright, who's next? Who's your next victim? Bellsprout. Yeah, let's switch. Go to Lapis, because, well, that's all I can switch to. Wedlocke. That's the point of it. Huh! Alright, Confusion! And then for Hoothoot, I think we'll just stay in with Lapis. I could always switch if need be, but I don't think we'll need to switch. Oh, actually, Hoothoot is Peck, doesn't it? I feel like, let's switch back. Back to Amethyst. Just in case, we could always switch to Lapis if things go wrong. The problem with Hoothoot is not actually using Peck, is it, Hypnosis is its problem. There's not much I can do about that, so I'm just gonna have to quick attack it. See how much I do. That's a decent chunk. Growl, okay. At least it's not Hypnosis. That is very good that it is not Hypnosis. And also, I made a mistake in the last episode. I haven't uploaded anything at the time of recording this, so no one told me. I just thought of it. Faulkner says you can kill him with electric attack, and I was all like, ha! You can't even get an electric type yet at this point in the game. Actually, if you went ahead and didn't, you know, before you fought the gym, went to the next route, you could have caught a Mareep. So technically you could before fighting him, but it's not before the route. It's like not an earlier route before him is what I meant by that. So, yeah. You and your Pokemon should have no problem using this move. Yeah, thanks. HMs. Thanks. Thanks, guys. Thanks. I appreciate it. HMs are great. Totally don't miss Sun and Moon right now. Alright, I will meet you guys somewhere. We'll see where that is when I get there. Alright, we're back, and we're going on this route. It's a fruit bearing. Sure, we got a Purrs Cure Berry! Alright, now I can cure Purrs! I'm really glad about that, because I hate Purrs. Alright, so, Route 32. Oh, wait a minute! Doesn't this guy block you if you haven't beat Falconer yet? Maybe you can't actually get Mareep. Maybe I was right the first time. I honestly don't remember, guys. Oh, Miracle Seed! That'll help my totally actual grass type that I absolutely 100% have. I might get one now. I believe you can catch Bellsprout here. I don't remember. Mareep is pretty common here to get. And grass type! Okay, thank you! Hoppip! I like Hoppip! I'm really happy to get that. Okay. Opal is up front, because Opal, I feel like, is not that strong, and it's gonna use friggin' Synthesis. Oh, well, that's okay. Tackle again. Splash. Okay. Okay, we're fine. We'll be fine. Don't worry. We'll be fine, unless I kill it. Thank you. Thank you for not killing it. Maybe that was a little risky. I just actually assumed it was gonna Synthesis, so that's why I didn't worry. Okay, yay! We're gonna get a Hoppip. And yeah, like I mentioned before, since we have a full party, gender means nothing at this point. It only matters when someone in my party dies and I have to pair someone with the new person no longer has a partner. It has to be the opposite gender, so I'm limited to who I can pair with whom. Alright, nickname for this Hoppip. Let's see, it was male. Okay, hold on. This is Silicon! Why Silicon? Mostly because I also included on my nicknaming theme things that I could also use the periodic table of elements, but I haven't actually used that yet. I've pretty much only done gemstones and granite. So, I wanted to spice up what I'm referencing for my nickname, so I just looked at the periodic table of elements, found something I thought that would make a good name, and I used that. And hey, Ekans, that would have been cool as well, but I am much happier with Hoppip. Honestly, I think Hoppip or Mareep would have been the best things I could have gotten here, so I am really happy about that. And I don't believe I can get cut yet. I believe, yeah, you get cut in a Ilex Forest. Yeah, that's right, so we can't go that way yet. So here's a trainer! If I'm not mistaken, this trainer and then the one below me, we can get their phone number. Or maybe not this guy? Is there Albert? Maybe not. I know there's a girl, like, looking at a rock, who's like, excuse me, I'm on the phone. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can get her number. I don't know about this guy. That's fine, I don't plan to get either of them. There's only a couple of trainers I plan to get their phone numbers, because, like I said, I don't want to get calls from a million different people, only my favorite people. So, and unless I've just gotten lucky, I haven't gotten any calls from anyone. So, well, I've gotten Youngster Joey and Wade, or have I? And I just forgot. I don't think I have. I feel like in HeartGold, SoulSilver, you get more phone calls, but maybe that's because it's the opt-out system rather than opt-in. They ask you as soon as the battle ends, so you're more likely to give out your phone number to more people, and therefore you're more likely to get more phone calls. Is that how it works? I don't know. It's a theory. And missed Supersonic twice in a row. Wow, good job, Zubat. If it does hit, I'll just switch, so this isn't an critical hit. Wow. Okay, game, you're making me get really lucky for absolutely no reason. Like, wow, there's no reason for me to be lucky there. That nothing would have happened differently. It just made the battle go a little faster. I don't want to go that way. Let's go this way and fight this girl. Let's heal Opal real quick, though. How many potions do I have? Five? Eh! There's a Pokemon Center before. Oh, there's a cave we're going to have to go through, isn't it? I may have to restock up potions, to be honest, before I go through that cave. Uh-huh, yeah, and you know, pardon? Battle? I'm on the phone. Oh, all right, but make it fast. You can talk on the phone while battling, you know, right? You don't have to actually do any actions except say your attack. Oh. Nidoran female, oh, cool. Okay. Go Opal. Yeah, I think we should be fine, because it's all it's going to do is probably tackle me. Maybe hit my poison sting. And I have... Oh, and Scratch. Tackle and Scratch, really? Really? That's a real good, nice allocation of your move slots. Although, I'm level 10, only have 2 moves, so what can I say? Alright! Of my Pokemon I have right now, I gotta be honest, I think Opal is the weakest. But I still have full faith that she will do at least okay for a while. She might easily get caught off guard or stuck in a corner, but we'll deal with that when the time comes. Oh, I've got to relieve my anger! What are you gonna do to relieve your anger? Oh, speaking of, I've never gotten a phone call. Amanda, howdy! It's me, Wade! Isn't it nice out? Are your Pokemon growing? Oh, you know, another thing about this game. You have to answer your phone. In our gold cells over the bottom screen just rings, and you have to click the phone button to answer the phone. I kind of like that better, because then you get to choose, oh, it's Joey again, I just talked to him, I don't want to talk to him. So, but in this game, it forces you to talk to them, so I don't know. It's an improvement. They're going a bit too quickly for me, it's overwhelming. You have bugs! That's the point of them, they grow fast! You felt sorry for the poor Caterpie you just killed. Well, maybe you shouldn't have killed it. Did you think of that, huh, Wade? It was nice, I was having a nice chat, too. Oh, you're on a big journey to the sites? Neat! Let's be friends! Can I have your phone number? I don't care about everything you've seen. What about taking out your anger on me? No! Aw, you won't be my friend? You just a second ago talking about taking out your anger on something. I don't trust you. I don't trust you or your emotions. Okay, so this is really embarrassing. Opal could not run from a level 5 Rattata. She couldn't run and she got hurt. She almost died, but didn't. I had to switch to turquoise, then run. So yeah, Opal, good job. I stand by what I just said not long ago, that you are the weakest member of this team. So, step it up. Step, please. And my Hoppip in the box is male, so I unfortunately cannot pair Hoppip with Totodile, because that would just be too good. So I guess I understand why I can't do that. Yeah, keep using Opal. Because I don't trust her. She should probably just be killed. That glance! It's intriguing. That's funny. Alright, Camper Roland with a Nidoran male. Oh, yeah, you're the male version of that girl we just fought. Okay. That makes sense. Alright. Horn Attack. Oh, that's not very nice. That's actually a decently strong move. It's better than Tackle and Scratch, that's for sure. Look what the Nidoran female had. I was gonna use Tackle, okay. Again, it doesn't matter what you do. Use whatever you want. Let's switch to Turquoise now, because Opal, you are not very good. I'm so sorry, but you are not very good. I wish you were, though. I wish Turquoise had a good partner, because he needs a good partner. He can't handle everything by himself, and I thought he should have ordered a Water Gun by now. But maybe their learn sets are different in second gen. I mean, their level up moves. Actually, I know for a fact they're different, because Ice Fang doesn't exist. But Ice Punch, as a TM does! So that's a good alternative. The only problem is, you know, all ice and water moves are special. And Feraligatr has much higher physical attack. So back then, in these old times, I guess you could make the argument that, I don't know, Feraligatr wasn't that good of a starter, but I'd make the argument that in the HeartGold SoulSilver with the new special attack, physical attack split, that Feraligatr is the technical objective best starter. And I'm not just saying that because he's my favorite. I just think he has the most amount of coverage moves by level up. Like water, ice, and dark, all by level up. And he's got really, really good attack power and bulk. So, see, Turquoise can run from things just fine. So, I guess my alligator runs faster than my squirrel. Go figure. And that was a Bellsprout, so there are Bellsprout here. I could have gotten that instead of Hoppip, but oh well. I'm actually happier with Hoppip because, I don't know, I feel like Jumpluff is less used than Victory Bell overall. At least the Nuzlocke's, because they're, I don't know, Bellsprout's in more games than Hoppip. Yeah, Turquoise, stay up front. You can handle this dude. Right? Yes, you can. I found some good Pokemon in the grass! I think they'll do it for me! Alright, let's see if they will. Show me your Pokemon. Youngster Gordon. Didn't we fight someone named Gordon already? Wooper! Oh, I think you guys Wooper here, dude! There's a lot of things in this route, isn't there? Wow. There is a lot of things in this route. I'm pretty sure. Oh, you know what I also didn't do? I didn't go to the Ruins of Elf. Although, do I need to or want to? That's a good question. I could. I don't think there's anything I can catch there except Unknown. And I don't really want to catch an. You can't actually can. Unknown are genderless, so they're not allowed in this Nuzlocke. I could. Later on, there's a different entrance to the Ruins of Elf that accesses some grass. I know you can catch Natu and Smeargle, and maybe something else there. That'd be nice to go to, because I'm pretty sure that's the only location you can catch Natu or Smeargle. So, that's a good Pokemon to have. Altitude was nice proof of that in the Soul Silver in Sandy Nuzlocke. Altitude the Zatu. And, I don't know, yeah, I feel like Zatu's still pretty good in this game. These old times, because, I mean, most Psychic attacks were special anyway. And Psychic is still pretty good, even with the addition of Dark and Steel in this game. Because there aren't that many Dark and Steel types. There really aren't. Anyway, I did not need to heal you because I'm pretty sure the Pokemon Center is right around the corner. So that was kind of, I think that was a waste of a thing, but that's okay. And you know what? Oh, Granite. How are you level 10? Oh yeah! You grew a level, okay. I thought he was level 11 for some reason. No. He's level 11, Jade is level... He's level 10, Jade's level 11. I thought it was the other way around for some reason, but I know that's not true. Those guys are fishermen. Let's actually not fight them. Okay, let's fight them. Yeah, great, you better. I'll just switch. Switching is fine. You know what? I don't think Goldeen even knows any water moves at this point. I think it only has Peck and Supersonic. Maybe Horn Attack. Because I know these trainers in this area, they have Goldeen and Magikarp. Maybe a Poliwag, or that might be a fisherman much later in the game. Alright, Granite, fight this Goldeen. Fairly certain it only has Peck, so I think we'll be okay. 1 HP, literally. Wow, good job. How much HP are we gonna do? Okay, a little more than one. This may take a little bit. I apologize for long-delayed battle, but I'd like Granite to get the experience from this, because he's the only one level 10 right now. So, yay. Also, I think Geodude's back sprite is pretty cool in this game. I know it's a really random thing to say. I don't know, I just feel like it's really well made. Most of the sprites in this game are really well made, don't get me wrong. It's just like, I don't know. Geodude looks especially good. I don't know why. I missed! What?! Missed at the last HP, you would. That would be the attack I would miss. Like, what else would happen in these playthroughs? Goodbye, Goldeen. That's a lot of experience. Wow. Almost grew a next level. Rock throw, yay! Time to rock. I tried to rush things. You can get his phone number too. I want to see what he says. Fishing is a lifelong passion. Pokemon are lifelong friends. Don't young people fish anymore? I've seen rare Pokemon while I've been fishing. You young people like that, right? Want to trade phone numbers? I'll let you know when I see anything, though. Oh, my own kids want to give me their phone numbers. Is that how young people are today? I like that guy. That's funny. Do I still want Granite up front? Yeah, he's almost grown another level, so why not? Whoa! You made me lose that fish! How? Because you got startled? How does that even work? I've gone fishing myself several times in my life. And just if someone startles me, I don't lose a fish. It's still on your hook. I don't know. Unless you're deep sea fishing or something and have to do this, like, a perfect reel in, bush forward, reel back in thing. There's a word for, there's an exact term for what I'm talking about. Someone more experienced in fishing might know that term, but, catching a small fish in the river here. You probably wouldn't need to do that method. Even if you did, you wouldn't have to do it for too long. Goodbye, Magikarp. That was fun. And this is, yeah, we're not gonna get much experience from this guy. Does he just have 4 Magikarps? I think he does. Just 4 Magikarps. It's fine. No, don't worry. It's fine. Don't worry. It's fine. It is fine. We got time. We're not in a hurry here. Not at all. I'd like to grow a level soon. That'd be nice. But that's alright. Magikarp! Also, the level limit for Bugsy, not that I'm following the level limit or anything, is 16. If I had any other starter but Totodile, I could have evolved my starter, but Totodile evolves later than other starters, so I will not be able to have Croconaw by Bugsy's gym, which is alright. I have a freaking rock type. Chances are I wouldn't want to use Totodile for that. I just realized the magic was level 15. I just noticed that. It's a freaking Magikarp, so obviously it's not going to do much damage to me anyway. So, yeah, I just noticed that now that it was 15. Oh, well. Yay, level 12! Good job, Granite! I really hope I don't take you for Granite, and then you die. I think this one's back to being level 5, yeah. 2 5s to 15, another 5. Good job. Jade Goosed! Goosed! Didn't kill it. You didn't kill a Magikarp in one hit. What the heck? Failure, Jade. Failure. Failure. Absolute failure. Try again. I hope my Pidgey in this game turns up better than other Pidgeys I've used, where they die as Pidgeotto. Meaning I've never gotten Pidgeot in a playthrough. My Pokemon freshly caught! Oh, I still have Granite up front. Crap, I wanted to put Jade up front. Oh well. But he probably just, what, has two Magikarp? Oh, Poliwag! Ooh! Well, that is something I absolutely have to switch for, because that does have a water move. So, Granite, get the heck out of there. Go to Jade. The only person I can switch to, because Wedlocke. Bubble! Oh, Bubble, not Water Gun. Same thing. Completely the same thing. Like, there's absolutely 100% no difference. Oh! Oh! That is bad. That is bad. I can't switch out. Bubble will one-shot Granite. So, Jade, you have to wake up. Well, I wouldn't give them the early bird ability right now. I don't think Pidgey can have the early bird ability, but I know it's an ability birds can have. Because, you know, it's a pun. An early bird. Kind of like how Big Pex is a pun. They like making puns for their abilities for bird Pokemon, I just realized. Jade, wake up! Wow, oh my god, guys, I think Jade and Granite are gonna die. I think Jade, okay, you woke up, thank you, how much damage are you gonna do? Half, at least half, please. No, that's not even half. It's gonna hypnosis again. Oh, you missed, thank you. Thank you for missing. Why don't I have I feel like I should have Quick Attack by now, but I don't. Quick Attack would be great right now, but no, okay, he didn't use hypnosis. Okay, we're fine. We're fine, unless he has another Poliwag. Guys, he has a second Pokemon. Another Poliwag. Oh no! Oh, this is bad! This is bad! This is bad. Okay, didn't use hypnosis. Okay, we're fine. We're fine so far, but three hits might be enough to kill me. No, it's not. Never mind. We're only gonna die if he uses hypnosis and hits. Oh, we did over half of that one for some reason. No! Ah! Jade! Well, darn it. Yeah, guys, I hope Jade lasts a while, and I hope I don't take Granite for Granite. Yep. To be fair, these guys were overleveled for Falconer's Gym, so maybe I deserve this. Because they overleveled, and I shouldn't have used them. Jade, if you don't wake up this next turn, you're dead. You have to wake up right now and kill him. Right now, you have to wake up and kill him. You woke up! Okay, Jade, are you and Granite just showing off or something? Are you guys just getting in really horrible situations just to get out of them and be like, ha! I got out of that situation! I do want a Slowpoke Tail, but oh, they're a delicacy in Alola. And no, $1 million? Wow. That's only like $1,000 US, so. Still a lot, but. Well, I think we're actually gonna end this episode here. I wanna go back and buy some more potions and balls, and then we're gonna go in this cave, and we're gonna hopefully not die. So, hope to see you next time. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. I just said that, sort of. So yeah, see you next time. Thank you for watching. Rock on.